A block is at rest on an inclined plane, making an angle theta with the horizontal, as in figure. Diagram में in a diagram in figure a block is shown on horizontal plane having angle theta and note this that the block is at rest as the angle of incline is raised as we raise the angle of inclination it is found that slipping just begins at an angle of inclination theta s is equal to 15 degree at an angle of inclination 15 degree the block just slips downward starts moving what is the coefficient of static friction between block and incline we have to calculate the coefficient of static friction when the block is just about to move and angle of inclination at that point is given here so we solve it this is the figure as stated in statement the angle of inclination theta this is block on an inclined plane when the block is just to move we have to calculate the coefficient of static friction in that case and in that case the angle of inclination is also given as 15 degree so we solve this problem as it is given that the block is at rest when the block is at rest it means that according to Newton's second law of motion the net force acting on the block is zero so that acceleration in it is also zero the block is at rest also we can say that by the condition of equilibrium the sum of forces on the block is zero as it is at rest in equilibrium and we can also resolve this condition into rectangular components as the sum of x component of forces acting on the block is zero and sum of y components of forces on the block is also zero this is the general view according to statement that the block is at rest so that from that term that block is at rest I have written this condition now we see how many forces are acting on this block and then we apply these conditions to calculate the coefficient of static friction as the block is on an inclined plane if the block has mass m then its weight is acting vertically downwards so if it has mass m then its weight is mg and weight mg is acting vertically downwards so this is one of the forces acting on the block the surface of this inclined plane also exerts a reaction force on the block block exerts force on inclined plane and surface of plane exerts a reaction force that is called the normal force on the block in a direction perpendicular to the surface so normal force is always perpendicular to the surface so this is normal force acting on the block and if we apply a force on the block if we apply a little bit force on the block to move it downwards then frictional force will act in opposite direction frictional force is always in a direction opposite to motion so when the block is just to move downwards again note that when the block is just to move vertically on the inclined plane downwards the frictional force acts in opposite direction So frictional force is Fs. Let's say that frictional force is Fs. This is frictional force, and we are asked to find the coefficient of static friction. So we have to find mu s, coefficient of static friction. So just understand about this diagram, how many forces are acting. The weight of the block downwards, vertically downwards, normal force perpendicular to surface of inclined plane, and the frictional force, that is called the static friction, in a direction opposite to motion of the block. This is force acting when the block is just to move. Block is not moving, but that is just to move downwards. As the block is at rest, so by Newton's second law, the sum of forces is equal to zero, or we can say that by first condition of equilibrium, sum of forces acting on the block is zero, and in terms of rectangular components, sum of x components of forces is zero, and sum of forces acting along y axis is also equal to zero. For our convenience, let us say that this is x axis, and this normal force is along y axis. So this is y axis, and perpendicular to it is x axis. Now we resolve the forces into x and y components. From here we can see that this force Fs is acting along x axis, and normal force N is acting along y axis. So this force Mg is making an angle theta with the x axis. So we resolve this force into its rectangular components. As here the angle between the horizontal and the inclined surface is theta, so the angle between the normal force, line of action of normal force, and the weight line, angle is also theta. How this angle is exactly same as this inclination angle, it is explained in the video, and I have shared a link in the description. So this angle is also theta between the normal force and the weight line. Now if I resolve the weight Mg into its rectangular components along normal line, then the component then its perpendicular component becomes Mg sin theta, acting along this direction, along negative x direction, and its horizontal component, horizontal with respect to y axis or normal force, its component becomes Mg cos theta. Now we can see that this Mg sin theta is acting along negative x axis, and Fs is acting along positive x axis. So by this condition that sum of forces along x axis is equal to zero, I write it as sigma Fx is equal to zero. Fs is acting along positive x axis, so Fs, and Mg sin theta is acting along negative x axis, so Fs minus Mg sin theta is equal to zero. From here I calculate that Fs is equal to Mg sin theta. I name it as equation 1. And along y axis we can see that this normal force N is balanced by the force Mg cos theta. So along y axis sum of forces is equal to zero, N is along positive x axis, and Mg cos theta is along negative x axis, so N minus Mg cos theta is equal to zero. So from here normal force, reaction force N is equal to Mg cos theta. We name it as equation 2. Now again see that very simple calculations, just we resolved the force Mg into its rectangular components, and then we saw that which forces are acting along x axis and which of the forces are acting along y axis, and then applying these conditions, we have got these two equations. Now, according to statement, it was stated that the block is just to move. When the block just starts its motion, then the static friction is given by the equation Fs is equal to mu Sn. When the block is just to move, then at that moment the static friction is maximum, and the maximum value of static friction is given by this formula mu S, the coefficient of static friction, and N, the force normal to the surface. As we have calculated the force Fs and N, so from equation 1 and 2, putting the values of Fs and N, before that we can simplify it as the coefficient of static friction mu S is equal to Fs over N. So I put value of Fs and N from equation 1 and 2, then I get the coefficient of static friction as mu S is equal to Fs is mg sin theta and N is mg cos theta. Here mg and mg cancel out each other. So coefficient of static friction mu S is equal to sin over cos, that comes out tan theta. So this is the value of coefficient of static friction in terms of theta. And from this equation, we can see that in case of an inclined plane, we can get the value of static friction independent of mass, independent of weight, or independent of normal force. Just we know the value of angle of inclination and we can get the coefficient of static friction. So at that moment the coefficient of static friction is, for static friction I can write with theta subscript as theta s, and it is given that value of theta s is equal to 15 degree at that moment. So mu s is equal to tan 15. After calculation we find that this value comes out to be 0.27. The coefficient of static friction is just a number and it has no unit. So its value is 0.27 in case when angle of inclination is 15 degrees. So this is a method, a very simple method in which we can calculate the coefficient of static friction independent of normal force. So again you can see the whole process as solved on this page. I tried to explain each term and each step so that you can better understand. Therefore video is little bit long, but that doesn't matter. If you thoroughly understand what I have explained here, then time doesn't matter. The main thing is that you should learn and understand what I have explained so that you can solve further problems easily.